Yeah.
Yes, yes.
The sky's gonna fall and it's gonna have
something like that was running all over.
Hey, do you know what
otherwise, I'm more than happy. I don't have a problem at all. We'll find a way.
Pretty straightforward.
Yeah, so incorporated master incorporated material with castles.
Yeah.
Yeah.
is Barry. Barry, you on? Sebastian is filming tonight. This is Chile. And I think you met him before. Okay, so this is the first flush.
Yeah. So it's something you work on yourself.
Write your name on the side of one of the strips and it's seen on the edge of the sheet.
Yes, now that's cute.
It's quite interesting.
This is
Philip. This is, oh wow, that's beautiful. Well, look at what it is.
Yeah.
The serpent was also present as a witness.
Disciplinary hearing.
Having been ejected from Eden.
Yeah. I dropped down there, yeah. As caretaker of God.
Yeah.
Yeah.
challenge and try to blame me.
Yes, that's it.
Yeah.
And if you look at it again, I think it's just coming out in the work that I'm going to do about work. It's not all me. It's just, if you look at the Calvinist type philosophy about work, it's, you know, work is good for you. It's important for you. Drives you, shows you the proper person.
Thank you. Yeah.
I have no idea.
No,
sure if you understand it. I'm not sure. Well,
I'm
Clarence is going to teach you.
Yeah.
Oh, they remind me a bit of Tom as well. Thank you. So they're very nice. All right. Anyone else's work? Because I'm going to come and do it.
Yeah.
UCD, we spent a long time in Italy in the autumn, and all of these are sort of Byzantine.
we'll have to continue.
That's actually just a plus. Also, it's a nice too. So, we're going to put one.
Nu, că n-am funcționat cum arată. Nu vreau să-l cumpăr, le-am cu telefonul.
Da?
Și eu și eu, apela.
Cum este că aveai 6 sau? Ziceai că aveai 6, nu? Sau?
Durează mult până să avează
așa mult?
Cred că la 6. Oh, mai am
as the name suggests, we have something in common,
but we're very different. And I'm hoping you've experienced that through your journey around this exhibition. There's a lot of rhetoric, you know, in the work, in the connections between us all, and again, hopefully, you know, talking to us, you've found out a little bit about where we're coming from, and I'm hoping that's something that you feel, you know, comfortable with, which is about promoting individuality. And I think, you know, there's we've got, I always think about this big round thing that's spinning around the universe, and we're all sitting on this thing and thinking, well, you know, what we're going to do next. We need to be thinking about each other, but we're very different. I've got a really good job tonight to basically introduce you to a fantastic poet that I just happened to trip over at KITKIK, Creative Innovation Centre from Taunton, called Graham Ryle. And he came to, basically reading poetry at KITKIK now for about 4 or 5 years. But the other night he came in and did this poem about Hinckley and about the nuclear, this crazy building that they're putting up up on the north coast of Somerset. And I mentioned to Graham, did you realise that you just read this poem in the middle of a Fukushima exhibition? And he's going, oh, really? Oh, wow. Anyway, connections. It's, you know, it's how we think, it's how you think, it's how we collectively think. And so this is a celebration of our individuality. I'd like to now hand over to Graham Ryan. Thank you very much.
Just firstly, I'd really like to thank Richard very much for the chance to come and read here this evening and to see such a wonderful and intriguing and stimulating exhibition. It's really, really good. Some fascinating conversations I've had. So, you know, it's a privilege that I can come and read here. I won't be reading for very long. Richard's going to stop me. He's going to go like that when I've sort of said all I'm going to say. But it's interesting because some of the stuff that I plan to read, I found some really interesting echoes, and just from what you've said, Richard, about the common and the different and the individuality. So I've been writing a lot of urban poems recently, even though I live in the countryside, and this one's called Listen. She says, even the glow at the tip of his cigarette as he sways at the top of the multi-story is connecting what was and what will be. As I find the thought to change his mind and turn the terrifying smack of the pavement into pictures he can imagine and step back from. Come with me past the spent needles and strips of foil, down the back alleys of dog shit and groundsel. We will arrive at the figures lost in sleep on blankets under the flyover. Sit beside this one. I will summon a memory of his mother's cradling from beneath the dreaming pillars of his concrete nursery. We will tend to the drunk, spewing his ring in flower beds by the magistrate's court, and watch the widescreen sky unreel its epic above the rooftops, finding ways to reach the others trapped at sunset, hidden and ablaze in their loneliness on immaculate sofas in the suburbs. The triage nurses work away as appointed in accident and emergency, and my light holds a vigil in the burns ward, rubbing ointment of gentian violet into wounds that weep no more. As I follow the evening light downriver, the child I was came back to me. I watched as the bruises faded, unfolding a luminous offer I never expected. In each bend and ripple of mirrored sky that salves and lavishes its gifts on us. Can you not see it? That is when I found I had healing in my touch. I still fear, but fear will not confine me. The world turns in all its pain, returns us with its blessing too. Thank you. I'd like to do that Hinckley one, which is quite an angry poem. I've made it into a 3-minute slam version because it's kind of like a bit of performance poetry, so if you want to enter a proper slam, it can't last more than 3 minutes, otherwise they'll guillotine it. But I'd like just to read just this other one here, and then maybe the Hinckley one. Okay. I recently won a competition with this one, which I was very fortunate to win. It was originally called The Homeless Man Thinks of Ancient Egypt. I was just driving in this evening and we saw someone who had a sign saying genuine army veteran, and it was just this lady. Maybe there was someone else, because it said genuine army veterans, so there might have been someone else there. And you know, it's just something we are habituated to. But I'm trying to think of a homeless person who actually, in their mental universe, was really fighting every single stereotype, every single negative feeling, every single bit of just rejection, and trying to switch it round so that they're not a victim. So this is the homeless man. Number one, he thinks of ancient Egypt. So this is the voice of the homeless man. I pray to the sun on these temple walls, the shifting angles and blaze of it, the way it melts the pavement ice mid-morning near the cash point. I imagine them as merchants, astronomers and viziers sitting at the window of the coffee shop opposite. Then they become slaves and slave owners, baboons manoeuvring the flow and current of glinting windscreens, tax collectors with the snapping heads of crocodiles that cancel me with an eye blink, asps and hawks and chattering ibis. I am sore beggar and heretic, but Horus shares the sun's strength with everyone, and for moments he lets me stop time, freezing the figures in KFC and Betfred the bonus king, jamming the screens inside Lloyd's Bank while Ra makes a gong bath out of the street roar. The gas workers toil in their jackhammer clatter on the banks of the traffic river. One squeezes the life out of a cigarette, the vapour of his breath in a shaft of sun, like the frost of my breath in this aching air. We are brothers under this midday moon I take for divination and augury. The sun's transit takes the blaze behind high roofs. There is a trapezium of light I shuffle to at the corner. It forecloses. Someone has brought me a coffee. Her glance contains a smile. I open the lid and take a careful sip. A packet of crisps too. The moneylenders have not quite taken over the temple. Anubis looks out through the eyes of a jackal-headed dog that walks up to me just out of reach. It sniffs the air. Way out of souls, tomb guardian, am I fit for paradise? Just like to read one more. This is 4 sections, but I'll just read one more. He dwells on money. There's quite a few echoes I've seen around. Afternoon. So this is number 2, he dwells on money. Then I'll do the Hinckley one, I'll finish then. Thank you so much for listening so beautifully and attentively. It's so lovely. Thank you. He dwells on money. This is the homeless guy. Afternoon casts its scallop of cloud on the sky sandbank above my new pitch. After I have settled, the sun comes squinting through slats of Venetian blinds. These alto cumulus I stare up at like a god. While even this pound coin, these 10p's, a laundromat token, and a clipped euro become voted offerings, an egg and cress sandwich on its sell-by that the man from the phone shop brought out to me, this bottle of water he puts into my hands. The estate agent's window would torch the heart. I mount spells in my head to make the magic to defeat it. I am learning the religious practice of holding my heat at the core beneath these vestments of cold. I send my thoughts into this chevron of high goals that catch the light on their breasts. After their day in the landfill, they have risen to angels again over the cliffs and brake lights of this city. Stacks and arches and promontories razor wired with money, the grind of peristalsis in the guts of it, money that squats and shits on all of us, flushed into inland seas. While the gulls steer their white sails into a different dimension. Thank you. I don't normally write angry poems. I'll just finish on this one. I don't really normally write angry poems, and I've been very troubled by Hinckley C. I've been very sort of, and I tried to sit on the feelings, and I tried to kind of work out, you know, is it just me being some kind of Luddite, and is it me not sort of being scientific, and is it me not thinking? And then I kept coming back to the same sorts of feelings. And then I just thought, you know what, I'm actually just going to express these feelings. So, HPC, Hinckley Point C. I see lots of people in Somerset wearing HPC t-shirts. Apologies to anyone here who's got work at Hinckley Point. This is something that I needed to vent. Okay, you may know someone. HPC, spoke one raven to another over Bridgewater Bay. In Xanadu did EDF two stately nuclear domes decree. The other, dipped his wings, replied, come, walk with me and be my love. Money tree whispers in the sacred grove. Talking Hinckley Point C, don't want to be guilty of hypocrisy. A station for the generation of 7% of the nation's electricity. Trying to share relation at the destination of Somerset's 21st century wealth creation. The new roads, roundabouts, business parks, wharves, piers, highways of information, funds for mitigation. The lorry loads of persuasion and industrialization, the sweet sensation of concretization, building new cathedrals for this nation, a boom time gold rush incarnation. So here's a stash of cash to let the movers and shakers take a standing ovation for. Cometh the man, cometh the hour of nuclear green power, say the powers that be. And in my ivory tower, don't want to be two-faced, so let's touch base. When I switch on the light, I expect electricity. When I charge my phone, I need that ringtone. I'm talking cognitive dissonance in my romance with science, my hypocritical alliance. Money tree whispers in the sacred dome. Come live with me, be my love. We'll walk the path and plight our troth. Missile and isotope, hand in glove. So let's call a spade a JCB. If there really is no alternative for two more of these motherfuckers that squat and hunker in such contrast to the Quantox, incredible hulks too costly to demolish in any foreseeable dawn chorus, then let's not fuck with the mother that bore us. Everywhere we touch the earth, it is sore from us. Why build C when you haven't cleared up A? It's shut down, can't you pay? Let's dedicate 50 nature reserves to compensate. Let's consecrate a sacred space in Somerset where we can all truly state and reiterate that we are grateful to this earth, grateful for its power. Like the Lakota Sioux, give thanks and show reverence to it. Respect the songline of the Aborigine, not the severance of it. Can only guess at the preciousness of this earth and have deeply thought about the mutable birth of tens of thousands of years of toxic waste, and that is only the half-life for 60 years of 7% power. Did you know there was a massive tidal wave up the Bristol Channel in 1607 that flooded miles inland? I'm just saying. Did you know the exclusion zone around Chernobyl is still the size of Greater London? Did you know Fukushima can't stop bleeding radiation into the Pacific, and they're still fishing? We need to be careful for what we're wishing, because if you don't want an enormous nuclear waste facility at the end of your road, why should any green field of England take the mother load? We're talking generations here. Two ravens over Bridgewater Bay croaked this parting shot as they flew away. Money Tree whispers in the sacred grove, come live with me and be my love. Go hand in glove. They cannot prove that we see wrong and they see right. For in the end, we all must bend to this blunt truth. This earth will yield for man's delight, and every person has their price. We split the atom. This, our choice. The earth is our tool. It has no voice. Thank you very much.
Yeah. Thank you very much, Graham Ryan. What a leader.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
If you want to hear a bit more of Graham Ryan's poetry, I was going to say rhymes. So
that's fine, Graham Ryan's.
You're performing tomorrow night, though.
Just a little bit, yeah.
So,
with Elizabeth.
Anyway, Graham, thank you so much.
No, thank you so much. Thank you.
Okay, enjoy the rest of the evening.
Yeah, we do. Jay, we'll see you later. I think we're going to go into the room.
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you. Let's see.